Suge, over 20 years ago, you founded Death Row Records, one of the most successful record labels ever. And Tupac was your biggest artist. Tell us about Tupac.
Tupac, he was a guy I had so much love for, so much respect for. I couldn't do nothing but put everything I had to do to make sure I got him signed to Death Row. I eventually felt this little brother I always wanted. And I never had a problem with Biggie. I always liked Biggie and thought Biggie was an incredible artist. In reality, my plan was to bring him to Death Row. And God stepped in and said, not today. That's not going to happen anymore.
You were talking about the Quad Studio shooting. What happened?
Pac ended up going to New York, and he ended up getting shot up. I know people were sending him, like, little gifts and flowers and roses and cards. And I sent him a bulletproof vest with the Death Row logo on the back and said, don't get scared now. When Pac died, if he really did, you know.
If he really died, what do you mean by that?
I mean, when I left that hospital, me and Pac was laughing and joking. So I don't see how somebody can turn from doing well to doing bad.
So you seriously think that he might still be alive?
I'm going to tell you this, Pac, you never know.
Oh, there you go.
And that's the realest answer I can give you.
Suge, what do you think happened at the Peterson Museum that night?
What's the Peterson Museum? I don't even know what that is.
The museum where there was that vibe party, which coming out of that, Biggie was shot.
I was in jail, like I'm in jail now.
Yeah. Yeah. But I'm sure that there was a lot of conversations about it. What do you think happened that night?
Well, first of all, I'm quite sure they know what happened.
Who's they?
The authorities.
When Ice and I run around and talk to people, they name you as the person behind the hit on Biggie.
Well, one, I don't know. I wasn't there. Two, that's not my style to want to see anybody life destroyed.
Tell me about David Mack.
I never met that man in my life.
The police officer, David Mack.
Never worked for me at all, never.
Suge, those names be popping on the streets. You know about Rafael Perez, Mack, and them doing the whole setup thing.
I never had a conversation with none of those dudes. Never met those dudes. They never worked for me. They knew Reggie right. They didn't know me.
So, Suge, I know you were in prison, but Ice and I, we've heard consistently, Suge, that you're the person behind the hit on Biggie.
Well, they looked at y'all and told y'all to ask live. If that's the case, did Tupac life mean anything? Because they never saw that case. Sometimes if you saw the first case, you might saw the second case. But that never happened, correct?
Yep.
If I asked you, who killed Tupac, who would you say?
Who pulled the trigger? Orlando Anderson, is what I've been told.
Okay, have anybody been arrested? Because it's not one person in the car. He didn't drive. He wasn't a driver and a trigger man, was he? I never had a problem with Biggie. I have no idea why it happened to him, where it happened at, or when did it happen, you know? Only thing I ever seem guilty for is not turning it down. If somebody's trying to harm me, I'm going to protect myself. If somebody messes with one of my artists or one of my friends, I'm definitely going to have their back. Loyalty is everything.